coyotes. I'm meteorologist John Weatherby.
The views expressed on the following program do not necessarily reflect the views of Money Radio staff, management, or advertisers, and do not represent an offer to buy or sell any securities. Some interviews heard on this program may be sponsored by the participants. It's time for Health Futures with Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth. This is Arizona's only show dedicated to providing you with expert advice on how to live a longer, healthier, and happier life. To learn more, call 602-264-8009. That's 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Bob Roth.
Good afternoon. My name is Michelle Cornelius, and I'm guest hosting our show today for Bob Roth. I work with Bob at Cypress Home Care Solutions as the Director of Memory Care Programs. If you're just tuning into the show for the first time today, Health Futures is a show about how our older adult population can live a longer, healthier, happier life. We've had the pleasure of bringing you this show for the past 4 years. And how do we accomplish this? We are able to do this by putting together an incredible lineup of guests. And today is no different. I'm happy to have on the show today Lisa Schmitt, director of the New Song Center for Grieving Children, a program of Hospice of the Valley. Welcome, Lisa.
Thank you so much, Michelle. Glad to be here.
Glad to have you here. Can you tell us about what you do?
Well, that would take a lot longer than we have. But in a nutshell, Michelle, New Song Center is the only ongoing grief support program that's targeting serving the needs of children and families in our community. And we've been around since 1989. I can't even believe that. But so we work with young children all the way from about age 4 or 5, all the way up to teenagers and young adults and their parents or guardians and grandparents as well. So we bridge all of the various generations in providing peer-to-peer support for kids and families after somebody they love has died.
Wow. And you know, Lisa, we're happy to have you here this time of year. We think it's timely going into the holidays when so many folks recognize that things are different than they used to be.
Exactly, exactly. This can be a very, very tough time for many in our community because the expectation is set forth that even before Halloween, which we just all celebrated, it's that pressure of all those holidays that are upcoming. And everybody is in the spirit, if you will, and we have this public persona that we're expected to put on. The anticipation of what that's like and how we can navigate that if we are grieving the death of a loved one, and whether that's recent or a death that may have occurred a long time ago. The holidays can provide some tricky moments for all of us.
How long do you serve folks after somebody has died? How long do you serve the family and those surviving?
Well, you know, New Song is a program that does not have a limited enrollment in the sense that families come to us at various times following their loved one's death. We typically recommend for children and families to get started with us not any sooner than about 45 days or so following the death, because there's so much transition that's taking place in those early days and weeks. Most of our families, on average, remain in our program enrolled in attending group supports every other week for about 13 to 15 months on average. We do have a special program called Enduring Ties, which is dedicated to serving the needs of families when a minor child has died. We see those families staying enrolled in our program usually a little longer than 2 years. So it's not a quick fix, if you will. Grief isn't addressed that way very effectively. And so we want to be there long-term for our families and children.
You know, I was at a session this week put on by Duet. Okay. And Dr. Pauline Boss wrote some books on ambiguous loss. And she was there and talking about grief and loss, both for people who have died and for folks who are taking care of people who have dementia, where you're losing pieces of the person before they have actually passed away, that grief before loss. Mm-hmm. And we were talking about the misnomer of closure.
Ah, yes, I'm so glad because oftentimes we hear the expectations from our participants who are in our group who say, people tell me, you know, it's been several months. It's time to move on. It was a year ago. Get over it. You should have closure by now. And honestly, in our experience, there is no closure. Grief is with us because that person was with us and will forever be a part of our life. And so, especially when you are a child and you mature into new developmental stages of your life, from a 5-year-old to a 10-year-old to a teenager to a young adult, each of those milestones of development cause us to revisit our grief and loss issues because we have a new understanding of what death and loss is all about. And so grief is not something that you get over, right? You don't get over it. And I think our audience listening today who have had a loved one die before are probably nodding in their cars or in their homes and saying, yes, that's so true, because you don't get over it. You learn to adapt and you live a new normal with the absence of the presence of the individual.
It is a new normal, and I think the holidays accentuate that.
Absolutely.
Because we may not have grandma's muffins anymore, or we don't have, you know, dad putting up the lights, or we don't have that child that's there who had such joy opening presents.
Right, right. And isn't that so true? Because the holidays are so packed with meaning and memory making, if you will, trying to figure out what we are capable of navigating, what we are not capable of navigating, can be a very tricky component to this season of time. And any way that we, Hospice of the Valley, New Song, and the bereavement services that we provide can become a resource to folks as they begin navigating those questions for themselves, we are anxious to be able to do that for families.
What do those services look like?
Well, they're very robust. In fact, Hospice of the Valley had an extraordinarily robust program of bereavement services prior to merging with New Song Center back, I believe it was 2009, time kind of flies. But when they added the New Song program, in addition to individual counseling with master's level or higher degree trained bereavement counselors, one-on-one counseling for individuals, anyone who had a loved one who was a part of Hospice of the Valley, they also have community referral bereaves, so that if someone did not have a loved one on service but might need a little assistance navigating the early stages of grief, we can make a community referral to those wonderful bereavement counselors. We also have multiple bereavement open support groups, peer-to-peer support groups that meet at various places all over our community. Some are daytime groups, some are evening groups. They typically meet twice a month. Anyone can drop in. There's no registration, and can find the support of others who are grieving in those open bereavement community groups. Periodically throughout the year, we also have specialty groups that meet. So if I'm a daughter whose mother died, Hospice of the Valley has a mother loss group, and we have special events for Mother's Day and Father's Day. So there are a wide range of services, plus then, of course, all the support that New Song provides to children and families. And the New Song program, although we are proud and honored to be a part of the Hospice of the Valley agency, families who are grieving may come to us regardless of whether they had a loved one on hospice care or not. So it is a community outreach arm of Hospice of the Valley. And all of those services are provided at no cost to those who are grieving. So it's a great honor and privilege to be able to communicate that once again in the community.
And I think that's so important. People often think, well, they weren't on hospice, or mm-hmm. they were on a different hospice,
mm-hmm.
and so they wouldn't qualify, but they also are worried about costs.
Right. And so I want to dispel that myth, if you will, that all of these services are provided at no cost. And even if an individual may not be seeking a bereavement counselor or a support group, if they just need access to resources, we can help them navigate what are available resources in the community and point them in the direction and make some contacts for them as well. So to use us as a great call-in resource.
Great. And we're coming up on our first break.
Sure.
So how should people access those services? Can you give us a phone number as we
sure.
come in?
Sure. Well, you can certainly call Hospice of the Valley at 602-530-6900, or you can go to hov.org at our website, and there's lots of resources and materials available on our website. And then the New Song Center phone number, direct access to New Song directly, is 480-951-8985.
Wonderful, Lisa. Thank you. As we come back from our first break here, we'll continue with Lisa Schmitt, director of the New Song Program, which is a program of Hospice of the Valley. We'll see you back soon.
Johnny Dean.
And I'm Rick, the Professor Plum.
Every day on Bucket Strategy Investing, we're talking about financial planning, investment decisions, and retirement strategies.
We focus on wealth education and the strategy designed for the needs you have today.
And the goals you have for the future. Tune in to Bucket Strategy Investing.
And call in with questions.
Retirement strategies, taxes, Social Security, and more. That's what we're talking about on Bucket Strategy Investing.
Did you know that every dollar you put in a piece of real estate makes you money five ways? Cash flow, money in your pocket each month. Equity capture, the thousands of dollars you create when you have the right team and buy the right property using the right map. Appreciation, real estate doubles in value about every 20 years. Equity buildup, renters pay down your mortgage each month. And finally, the tax advantage. We pay almost no taxes on our cash flow and capital gains. These are the five ways we make money in real estate, which is why real estate accounts for more millionaires in the world today than any other investment vehicle. You should have some real estate in your portfolio. To learn how, attend one of our free workshops. Call 866-971-8970 or go to luiphoenix.com and register for the next available workshop. That's 866-971-8970 or go to luiphoenix.com.
The Wall Street Journal Tourism Index has dramatically outperformed the S&P 500 since January of 2016, and the Private Deal Guy knows that better technology, transportation, and information are driving the growth. Visit PrivateDealGuy.com to discover how the Private Deal Guy and his partners are diversifying their portfolios in the travel industry. All material should not be construed as specific recommendations or investment advice. Always consult with your investment professional before making important investment decisions. Your chance to start earning extra money begins now. Apply to be a part-time or full-time associate in Phoenix at amazon.com/phoenix-jobs. Amazon is an equal opportunity employer.
Now back to Health Futures, taking stock in you. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth.
Welcome back. This is Michelle Cornelius filling in for Bob Roth today at Health Futures. If you missed the first segment, I'm here with Lisa Schmitt, director of the New Song Center for Grieving Children, which is a program of Hospice of the Valley. We've been talking about grief and loss in many ways. And as we ended the segment, we had started to talk some about the holidays and how it can be a benchmark for what's happened in previous years. But I know that you have a lot of programs going on to help folks through the holiday season.
We do. And one in particular that I would love for our audience to be made aware of, it's coming up pretty soon. It's actually Wednesday night, November the 8th, and it's being hosted by Hospice of the Valley and sponsored by Comerica Bank. So we want to give them credit for making this possible. But the whole concept of how we navigate the holidays, coping with grief during the holidays, and it's being held at the Granite Reef Senior Center up in here in Scottsdale at 1700 North Granite Reef Road. And there'll be two folks who are co-hosting that in terms of the speakers. We have one of our bereavement counselors, Joyce Vidal Thornburg, who has been with Hospice of the Valley for many, many years. And then a member of my staff, Gary Anderson, who actually started out with us as a volunteer and has now celebrated more than 10 years with us at New Song Center as one of our evening coordinators and volunteer coordinators. So we'll be talking about tips and techniques and challenges and opportunities that the holidays bring. And we are encouraging anyone, it is a free event. event to the community, and we're encouraging everyone to carve out that little bit of time on Wednesday evening and come and attend that event, because I think it will be a valuable resource and guide to helping people figure out what is this holiday season going to look like.
That sounds like an amazing program.
Yeah.
And really timely right now.
Mm-hmm.
How do people register for this class?
To register, like I said, it's free. The phone number is 602-636-5391. That's 602-636-5391. Or they can go to events and then the number 5@hov.org. So HOV.org will get you into anything and everything that Hospice of the Valley provides. So, and it's no cost to attend, and it's up at the Granite Reef Senior Citizen Senior Center this Wednesday evening. It starts at 5:30 with check-in. There'll be refreshments. Food is always a good thing, right? And the presentation is 1 hour, 6 to 7, and then there'll be a Q&A from 7 to 7:30. So it'll be really valuable time well spent. If you have any questions at all about how am I going to navigate this for myself, how do I help somebody I know who is grieving? And oftentimes that can be the most difficult part of all, I think, is that I know a dear friend of mine is grieving, and I have no idea what to say. I have no idea how to help, what is helpful, what isn't. And I know children. What do I do? How do I do it? Because I think many of us have had the unfortunate experience of people either kind of going AWOL on us, right? Because they don't know what to do and they're uncomfortable,
right?
Or they say the wrong thing and it just reaches to our heart and pierces our heart in a way. Not because they have an intention to hurt us, but because they just don't know. And
right.
So how can we navigate that? So if you're one of those people who is in a caregiver role or is trying to support someone who is actively grieving, this presentation is for you as well, not just for those who are grieving themselves.
And you know, I specialize in folks who have dementia.
Sure.
And I help people who have dementia. And so often care partners, even though they're going through this loss with mm-hmm. the disease process, don't feel like they can take time to attend an event. What a wonderful thing for a neighbor or a friend or somebody from your faith community to do.
Absolutely.
To go and learn how to support that care partner
right.
in this process.
And you know, I think you've touched on a really important point, as a matter of fact, and that is true, that when we are grieving or when we are caring for someone who has a dementia diagnosis or we have a lot of responsibility, our lives become very, very full. And just being able to carve out that time and get away can be very difficult because you don't want to be away from those that you love the most. And so as a friend or an extended family member or somebody from the faith community, like you mentioned, learning some things about how to be helpful to those that we care about, it can be extraordinarily valuable, and resources that you can offer to them and provide for them. So yes, it's for those who are grieving, but also for those who want to support those who are grieving.
That sounds wonderful. I know that in organizing this, then you said you have two grief counselors, bereavement counselors,
right,
that will be there to lead this.
Yes. Well, one is a bereavement counselor,
okay,
by profession, and one on staff with Hospice of the Valley in that capacity. And then Gary is not what you would call a bereavement counselor per se. He is our evening coordinator for the Gilbert and Scottsdale locations at New Song Center. And so he does not have a degree in bereavement counseling per se, but has worked with us for more than 10 years. And Gary started out as a volunteer facilitating a grief support group of teenagers. Now, anyone brave enough and bold enough to do that, you know, has a heart of gold. And Gary has just amazing insight and understanding of how to be supportive of and helpful to children and to parents or guardians, those who are caring for children as they grieve. Because sometimes it's the parent who has died, and grandparents or older folks who are now caring for younger children again. And I know Duet, you mentioned them earlier, they have some wonderful services that support the grandparents raising grandchildren. But
right.
Gary's going to bring that focus in on how do you support children and families during this time frame.
Excellent. You know, I have a friend that I grew up with back in Illinois, and his wife died when their children were very young.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the homes there that does similar, I think, work, it sounds like, mm-hmm. has been invaluable to his family and to mm-hmm. his children mm-hmm. to be able to recognize how to get through each day without mom.
Yes.
And how to do that kind of things. Now, with kids, there's different techniques and different words and things that you use.
Oh, right? Words matter so much. And while we were off air for a moment, we were talking about it. But one of the principles of New Song Center is that our words do matter, and we want to be very careful. And the reason they matter, and anyone who has had children or has been around children or who has worked with children, know the younger the child, the more concrete thinker they are.
Mm-hmm.
And they're less living in that abstract world we adults tend to live in more comfortably. And so the words that we use when we talk to children about when someone has died, it can really be very, very confusing. So a tidbit that I might throw out to our audience today to consider is, what are the words that we're using, and where do we come from? Oftentimes it's family culture, family traditions, but imagine what those words sound like to the child who is 5 or 6 years old. We lost mom, or we lost grandma. Well, a 5-year-old only understands lost as, well, I lost my teddy bear. And so then there's these concepts of, well, if they're lost, what's the natural thing we do? We go find them, right?
Right.
And so then the parents get confused because the child keeps saying, well, let's go get grandma. Well, no, I told you we lost grandma last week. Well, there's a confusion, a breakdown of communication. And so the more concrete we can be, the more precise we can be, and the simpler we can be, the younger the child. At New Song, we're very comfortable with the D word. And I know a lot of our audience members may not be. You know, we're very comfortable speaking to a child and saying, your grandma died and her body stopped working. And that sounds, well, of course, as an adult, yes, the body stopped working. But when you're talking to a very young child, so avoiding euphemisms and avoiding, we earlier spoke about our faith communities. And being very careful about the language that we use about maybe God needed your mom or God needed your brother or sister. We start conveying a message to a very young child. Well, if I'm 5 years old, I really need my mom. Why did God need my mom more than me? It's very confusing. And you get into theological discussions that are a little difficult for younger kiddos to understand and grasp.
Well, and if you're going through a grief process at the same time, and now we're also dealing with our own grief at the time, we're trying to explain to a young child
what has happened. It gets more complicated, yes.
It has to be, right, not just complicated logically, but emotionally for us as well.
Of course, and that you make a really wonderful point. And one of the things that so often is difficult is as many of us are parents, we worry constantly about our children, and we care for them, and we're constantly concerned for them, no matter how old they are. My daughter will be 31 on her next birthday, and I still worry. But when what we don't know often or don't recognize as parents is our children worry about us as well. And when
right.
our family has faced the death of a loved one, children are very anxious and worried on behalf of their parents. And so that breaks down what might otherwise be normal communication and creates barriers between even loving and most functional and highly regarded families. It can make that much more difficult during, and then you add the layer of the holidays as another barrier, another stress. It just gets complicated. It's like everybody has 5 balloons and they're all trying to keep all 5 balloons up, and there's 5 members of the family. That's 25 balloons all trying to stay up, right?
It's a lot to do at one time.
And so we try to help families simplify that and understand that.
Wonderful. Well, we're coming up on our halftime break here, Lisa. It goes so quickly. When we come back, we're going to continue our discussion and maybe some tips and tricks on getting through the holiday season. So we will see you back very soon.
As we reach the bottom of the hour, we pause for a look at the world's news. Then we're back with Money Talk. We're Money Radio 1510 AM and 105.3 FM.
House Republicans have made a change to their big tax overhaul, making tax cuts less generous. Ways and Means Committee Chairman Kevin Brady would adjust tax brackets immediately instead of 2023, which means more income would get taxed at higher rates over time. President Trump is in the air on his way to a 10-day tour of Asia. Correspondent Christian Amanpour tells us he may cross paths with Russian President Vladimir Putin at a conference in Vietnam.
It's likely that they will in some form or fashion, because that's going to be in the Vietnam leg of the trip, and Vladimir Putin has tended to be at those meetings, and yes, has meetings with all the major leaders.
The NYPD says this Sunday's New York City Marathon will be held under the tightest security ever. Extra officers and snipers are being added along the marathon route after this week's deadly terror attack in Lower Manhattan. Army deserter Sergeant Bo Bergdahl sentenced today to dishonorable discharge but no prison time for leaving his post in Afghanistan. I'm Michael Toscano.
Hello, beautiful. I'm Amy Arrett, founder of Madison Reed, a hair color company I named after my daughter. I founded Madison Reed with the idea to create luxurious, ammonia-free, salon-quality at-home hair color that saves women time and money. Thanks to all of you, it's working. From New York to Florida, California to North Dakota, women all over the U.S. are trying and loving Madison Reed. Whether you're a busy mom, an executive, or a beauty fanatic, this is hair color that gives you the freedom to do more of what you love. This is hair color for all. In under an hour and less than $25, Madison Reed delivers gorgeous, multi-dimensional, shiny hair. Join the hundreds of thousands of women who have discovered a better way to color. Find your perfect shade at madison-reed.com and get 10% off plus free shipping on your first color kit. Use code FUN123. That's code FUN123.
For a happier life, remember, it's your money. Be smart with it. And listening every day to Money Radio will cause your money IQ to go up, way up.
Hey, Money Radio listeners, this is Gary Kaufbaum. Make sure you tune in for my show, Investor's Edge. You'll get my take on the markets and the world and what to look out for tomorrow. Investor's Edge is one of Money Radio's longest-running shows, so don't miss it.
You can listen to Investor's Edge Monday through Friday at 5 p.m. here on Money Radio 1510 AM and 105.3 FM.
It's back. Showroom football at Casino Arizona. Join the Fanatic hosts, Rock, Mnuch, Fooey, Bauer, Monty, and others all season long at Casino Arizona every Monday night to win your share of over $20,000 in cash and prizes. The promotion's free. Just be 21 or older, a member of the Player Rewards Club, and be present in the showroom. That's Mondays at Casino Arizona, Loop 101 in McKellips, for Monday's Showroom Football.
Have you been turned down for a mortgage loan recently or still interested in buying a home? There may be a way now. Hi, Joe Capitano here, Senior Vice President, Homeowners Financial Group. There have been some recent changes in how lenders qualify borrowers that could make a difference in your ability to buy. Until now, most lenders would not allow you to qualify if you added up all your monthly obligations, divided them into your gross income, and if it was more than 45%. Now, in some cases, they'll allow that to go up to 50% of your debt-to-income ratio. That could be just the difference it takes to qualify you. Also, credit reporting is changing. Most credit bureaus are no longer going to report most judgments, which could make a difference and dramatically improve your credit score. If you feel any of these items could help you, maybe the lender didn't work hard enough for you, call me, Joe Capitano, 480-305-8545, or just go to joeloans.com. Becker number 090-6222, MLS number 98826, Equal Housing Lender.
Be sure to listen to Joe every other Friday on Mastering Money, right here on Money Radio.
Suffering from knee or back pain? Call 800-616-KNEE and learn how a comfortable, nearly invisible brace can solve your problem. 90% satisfaction rating. 800-616-KNEE.
Bruce Vail with Your Money Now. Paramount Pictures is deepening its relationship with Hasbro. The Viacom-owned movie studio said it will work with the toy company over the next 5 years on live-action and animated films based on Hasbro brands, expanding a partnership that has so far included the Transformers and G.I. Joe franchises. Paramount and Hasbro will co-finance projects under the deal as well as produce TV programming. Movie theater operator Cinemark is starting its own subscription service called Cinemark Movie Club, set to be launched in the U.S. by the end of the year. The company said it has been working on the program for most of the year but didn't want to give out too many details. On Wall Street, stocks remain higher in the final hour of trading, but the Dow Jones Industrial Average is now up just 5 points. The NASDAQ is up 42, and the S&P 500 is ahead 6 points. Crude futures gained 2%, ending the week at a two-year high. That's your money now.
Hello? Anyone there?
Hey! United Healthcare heading your way.
Thank goodness.
Lost in the giant Medicare maze?
It's so complicated.
No worries. United Healthcare has the people, tools, and plans to get you through it, including the only Medicare plans with the AARP name.
I'm so glad you found me.
Need to find a Medicare plan? Get help now at UHCMedicare.com. AARP Medicare plans from United Healthcare. United Healthcare pays royalty fees to AARP. AARP is not an insurer.
Are we ready to open next month?
I think so.
You think so?
Well, it's complicated. Fire protection, first aid supplies, uniforms, safety training, mat services. Oh, and restroom supplies.
So uncomplicated. Call CentOS. They'll handle all of it.
Wow. One company can handle all that? That's not very complicated.
So, we'll be ready?
Oh, we'll be ready.
Oh, I'm ready!
Learn how CentOS can help you get ready for the workday. Visit CentOS.com.
Now back to Health Futures, taking stock in you. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth.
Welcome back to Health Futures, Taking Stock in You. This is Michelle Cornelius. I work with Bob Roth at Cypress Home Care Solutions. If you've missed the first two segments of this show, you can go to our website at cypresshomecare.com and you can click on the media link button. If you scroll down to the radio show, you can find this show, all of its segments, and about 160 other shows that we've been bringing you for the past 4 years. In the first half of the show, we've been talking with Lisa Schmitt. She is the director of the New Song Center for Grieving Children, a program of Hospice of the Valley. We've been talking about people who are have lost a loved one, or when we're working with children, when a loved one has had the death of a family member. We talked about the importance of the words that we use through that. We promised when we got back from break, we'd give some tips and tricks in going to the holiday season and in how, if you have lost someone, if somebody has died in your family, or if you have a friend or a family member who has had somebody die, how to help them cope through the season. So, Lisa, I'm going to turn this over to you, and we're looking for some good tips and tricks here.
Well, you know, I think recognizing where you are and being able to be transparent as best as you are able with your family members, whoever may be there, whether there are children in the home or not, recognizing that your feelings may change. Grief is like a roller coaster, and many, many families or individuals have talked to us, I feel like I'm crazy. You're not crazy, you're grieving, and it's a lot of unexpected change. And so noting and recognizing that can be a great first step to say, yeah, I'm not my normal self. Nothing feels normal to me. This may sound crazy to you, but the best advice that we can offer is to talk to the other members of your family about, okay, gang, the holidays are coming up. It's going to be different this year. What is everybody thinking? What is everybody wanting? And get that on the table so that those elephants are not any longer in the room. That if people have different sets of expectations, getting it out ahead of time can certainly go a long way in smoothing some of the rougher edges that might be headed our way. That's the first thing. And recognizing what your limits and boundaries are. Off air, I was telling you about a mom who had three little guys, and her husband had died, their father. And she says, I can't do the holidays, I can't decorate. But the children still wanted to decorate. So she compromised and said, okay, I'll help with getting the tree, getting it out, getting it in its stand. That's as far as I can go, and I can point you to where the boxes are. The boys got the boxes out, and the tree got decorated halfway up that year. You know what? To anyone else in the world, that may have looked really odd, but to that family, that was perfect for that year. And giving yourself permission not to follow through with all the same traditions as always.
I talk about that with our caregivers who are taking care of somebody or care partnering with somebody who has dementia as well.
Mm-hmm.
That talking to the family ahead of time and picking and choosing what pieces are important right now.
Yes. So because much, and eliminating stress that way, right? Because you don't have to do everything
right
that you've always done.
And, you know, I had one family last year who said they thought it was so important that grandma's rolls were made at Thanksgiving.
Okay.
And when the family sat down together, they realized nobody ate the rolls anyway.
Mm.
And it was a tradition that they thought was very important. But as they started to actually plan and pare down the meal, they realized it's okay,
yes,
if we don't have grandma's rolls this year.
Which goes back to that first conversation, right? If you can sit your loved ones down together, and it may be several conversations about what is expected, what do I want, what am I willing to give in on, and then talk through the role conversation. I think that's a great example of we think it's important, but maybe it's not as important as it sounds like.
Right.
Or maybe it is, and maybe we still want to make them even though nobody wants to eat them.
And I think if it's important to you, also putting it out there and asking if others are willing to participate.
Yes.
If it's important to you to still have mom's apple pie, are you willing to make mom's apple pie or help mom make the apple pie? Because mom may not be able
to
have the energy to do that this year.
But being willing to simplify, right?
Right.
Because holidays, under normal circumstances, can be extraordinarily stressful, just normally. Recognizing that you're not your normal self, how can you reduce stress for yourself and for your loved ones and family members? So, and then the other thing, too, that seems apparent but maybe not, is giving yourself permission to change your mind.
Right.
Oftentimes we get flooded with invitations about going to this event or this party or that church service or what have you, and we may be overwhelmed and don't want to, or we may want to, and then the day of the event, we're having a tougher day and change our mind. Giving ourselves permission to be flexible. I love the image of Gumby, our little green guy. Everybody knows who Gumby is. Well, he's the New Song Center mascot, and that's because grief requires us to be very flexible and giving ourselves permission to change our minds.
Right, and like you said, it can be right at that last moment,
mm-hmm,
that it's okay if you pull up outside and you decide not to walk in.
Exactly.
And my recommendation for the family member or friend who's expecting you to walk in the door would be later call and say,
follow up.
You know, we missed you, but if you needed that time, I'm glad that you went and did what you need for yourself.
And on that note, I think that's a great segue. So if you know someone who is grieving and you are at a loss as to how to be a loving, kind, compassionate friend or family member, follow up. Don't say, let me know how I can help. I'm here to help. Don't be vague and open-ended. The person that hears that message probably doesn't know what they need themselves. So say, you know, if you're available, I'd love to take you to coffee on Tuesday morning. Would that work? Then be flexible if they ultimately change their mind. Or say, you know, I'm running to the grocery store. How about I bring you some fresh vegetables and things for a salad? Not, can I get you anything at the grocery store? You know, or say, hey, I've been to the grocery store. I have this. I'd love to drop it off. You know, here's dinner tonight. You know, food and grief go together, as many
right
of us know. I'm Southern, and so food and tuna casseroles and grief and food all
go
together, right?
Midwestern, and we're the same.
Exactly. But what happens is, what happens when all the tuna casseroles are gone?
Right.
That initial period after a loved one has died, we get all that attention and all that support. And then a month later or 6 weeks later or 2 months later, the casseroles are gone and the calls have stopped and the visits are over. The family has gone home to their respective homes. And then there's the quiet, more isolating time. As a friend, I would encourage, don't let up. don't be afraid to say, how are you doing today? The question is, how are you doing is very open-ended, right? Well, as a bereaved person myself, my smart aleck answer would be, well, how do you think I'm doing? My loved one has died. Okay. But if you say, how are you doing today, it's a little bit more appropriate way of just as a daily check-in that day. Where are you right now?
Right.
Today's a good day. Today's a not so good day.
And I
so
was talking specific. To a lady yesterday who said she didn't like that question. Her husband just passed away. And I said, it's okay to say, I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
She said,
mm-hmm.
really? I said, mm-hmm. absolutely. It's okay to say, I don't know how I'm doing today.
Right.
That's okay.
And it's also okay, with permission from the bereaved, to talk about the loved one. Oftentimes we are told that the most special time is being allowed to speak of our loved one who has died by name.
Mm-hmm.
And so often everyone tiptoes around because they don't want to make you cry. Well, at New Song, we don't have a lot of rules. One of the rules is it's okay to cry. And crying is a perfectly human, natural response. If I want to talk about my loved one, I will. If I don't, I won't. But being given that sense of permission to be able to go there.
Excellent. Thank you, Lisa. We're coming up on the end of this segment. We'll return soon. This is Michelle Cornelius with Health Futures, taking stock in you.
Hey, Phoenix, Larry Kudlow here. Be sure to join me every Saturday at 2 p.m. on the Southwest's longest-running financial talk radio station, the one and only Money Radio. And during the week, don't miss Mastering Money with hosts Steve Jurich and Ken Morgan daily at 8 a.m. right here on Money Radio 1510 a.m. and 105.3 FM.
For podcasts, download the free Mastering Money app for both Apple and Android and visit MasteringMoneyRadio.com.
Did you know that some travel stocks are up over 300% in 5 years and even 1,400% in 10 years? Visit PrivateDealGuide.com and learn how you can diversify your portfolio into the travel industry and sign up for your free report titled Why Invest in Travel and Tourism. Go to PrivateDealGuide.com now. All material should not be construed as specific recommendations or investment advice. Always consult with your investment professional before making important investment decisions.
Did you know azbigmedia.com was named the website every Arizonan should know? For more than 30 years, AZ Big Media has brought readers the state's most compelling business and lifestyle news through newsletters and award-winning publications such as Arizona Business and Ranking Arizona Magazine. Stay informed with all your business, real estate, travel, and lifestyle news at azbigmedia.com. See why BuzzFeed named azbigmedia.com one of the top websites in Arizona. Visit azbigmedia.com today.
Have you been in an accident? Don't let the insurance companies tell you where to bring your vehicle. Call Sam's Auto Body and Paint today. A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau. Sam's Auto Body and Paint handles all insurance claims, and in most cases, Sam's pays your deductible. Accidents happen. Sam's Auto Body and Paint is there to repair your vehicles back to its original function and strength with 100% satisfaction and a lifetime warranty. They also offer free towing. For more information, visit samsautobodyandpaint.com. That's samsautobodyandpaint.com. The professional collision repair specialist.
Ready for a bad cold and flu season? A cold is a cold, but flu brings fever. Be prepared with the Exergen Temporal Scanner Thermometer, backed by medical professionals everywhere.
Now back to Health Futures, taking stock in you. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth.
Welcome back. This is Michelle Cornelius filling in for Bob Roth from Cypress Home Care Solutions. If you've missed the first segments of these shows, you can go to our website at cypresshomecare.com and find all of the segments from today's show and all of the other shows that we've been bringing you. I'm here today with Lisa Schmitt, director of New Song Center for Grieving Children, a program of Hospice of the Valley. And I wish you could have been with us even throughout break. Lisa and I have had wonderful conversation today, and in a subject that not everybody's comfortable with, talking about death and talking about ways to support people who have died and the families that surviving those. And even in our break here, we're talking about the words that we use. We talked about that a little bit in one of our other segments and how important it is to the surviving family to name the person that they've lost.
Exactly. And to feel as though they're not making others uncomfortable. Oftentimes in our culture, it is natural to say, "Oh, I'm so sorry for your loss." I've said that more times than I can count. That's a natural conversation. And what happens then is the person who is grieving then frequently feels as though they must comfort you.
Right.
And it becomes about you and not about them. And just inviting them to tell you about their loved one if you didn't know them, or to share your own memory if you did. One of the best conversations I ever had was with a very dear friend whose mom had died, and her mom and I had been friends for years. And to just talk about her mom and to share the things about her mom that I loved. Oftentimes there are stories and memories that maybe the family may not have because it was their loved one in a different setting outside of them. And they're so cherished when they learn that their mom did this or did that. And so being able to have that permission to talk about their loved one by name. And if you don't know their loved one who died, to be able to say, what was the favorite thing you used to do with your mom or your dad? Or, you know, tell me about your mom. I didn't have the pleasure of knowing her. And so, you know, allowing the person, if they're comfortable, to talk about it, because honestly, they'll say, you know, I'm just not up to that today, but thanks for asking. They'll appreciate it.
That's a wonderful tip. Now, I know you have other tips, and I know there's a lot available on the website as well.
Yes.
So
yes.
Can you share the website with us and then give us a couple more tips?
Sure. The Hospice of the Valley website, and we have a whole series of bereavement newsletters that are up, and I didn't talk about that. Those newsletters are available, quarterly newsletters that go out, lots of great resources. The Hospice of the Valley website is hov.org, and then just go to grief and loss, and there'll be lots of resources there, articles about various types of experiences and circumstances, and tips for parents who are parenting children, how to be the best parent you can be while you yourself are grieving and parenting grieving children. So lots and lots of resources at hov.org. And I also want to again remind our listeners that Hospice of the Valley is hosting a free Coping with Grief During the Holidays event sponsored by Comerica Bank on Wednesday night of this week, which is Wednesday the 8th. Check-in starts at about 5:30. It's at the Granite Reef Senior Center. I can't say that very well. I don't know why. Starting at 5:30 for check-in with light refreshments. The presentation is from 6 until 7. And then from 7 until 7:30, we'll have an informal Q&A for folks to have specific things. But the Granite Reef Senior Center is on North Granite Reef Road. And to RSVP for that is to call 602-636-5391. Or events and the number 5 at hov.org. And then if I may, there's one other special event that's coming up as well. That's an annual event. If you are grieving the death of a loved one or know anyone who is, Hospice of the Valley hosts annually on the Sunday prior to Thanksgiving in the evening a beautiful, beautiful event honoring and remembering our loved ones who have died. It's a very lovely event outdoors, rain or shine, no matter what the weather. And some years we've had wind and some years we've had rain, but it goes on either way. Outdoors at the park at Steele Indian School, just at Indy School Central.
Location.
It's a beautiful location, right, overlooking the lake, where we have a photo montage set to music of photos that have been sent to us by family members of loved ones who have died. It is absolutely the most meaningful and beautiful bereavement event I think I've ever attended in my entire life. And it's coming up the Sunday before Thanksgiving in the evening from 6 until 7. You can also, it's too late to submit a photo this year. That deadline has passed, but we have a beautiful table, memorial table, and you can bring a photo of your loved one as well to share in that experience. We have cookies and cocoa. We have ornaments to hang on trees honoring our loved ones who have died. And, you know, in the neighborhood of 1,200 or more people come, bring a lawn chair, we do have chairs, but bring a blanket. It's a lovely, lovely outdoor event that honors and remembers our loved ones. And so that's also coming up. And no RSVP is required for that. You can just come to that event.
Thank you for sharing that.
Yeah.
I am always blown away by the number of resources and events that Hospice of the Valley has for the general community.
Absolutely. As am I. I am honored to be a part of the most wonderful agency that I've ever worked for, and I'm no spring chicken anymore. But Hospice of the Valley really is committed to serving our families regardless of the circumstances, and their community outreach to provide after a death loss support for anyone in our community, regardless of whether their loved one is on hospice. New Song Center serves family, whether it was a sudden and unexpected death or an anticipated and hospice-related death, all types of circumstances. And so, yes, Hospice of the Valley continues to be committed to providing resources. We have a full library. If somebody is a reader, they can call in and we can offer them some ideas about books and resources. We also have a booklet that we produced for our bereaved families that's called Coping with the Holidays. And if they'd like to call into Hospice of the Valley or call into the New Song Center, that would be the best.
Can you give us that number again?
At 480-951-8985. 480-951-8985. And I will personally make sure that you get a copy of the Coping with the Holidays booklet. That's a tool that individuals and families can use as they prepare to think through how they want the holiday season to go, because we recognize it can be tricky. And even if they just want someone to talk to at the New Song Center and ask questions about and help get pointed towards resources that we know are available in our community, we're here for our families, and that's a really privilege for me to be a part of that.
And I want to remind folks that we said very early in the program that it's not about just the first holiday after somebody has died. This is about years ongoing. Things change in your life, and the things that we have lost throughout the years. We lost the mom who might be there for our wedding. We've lost the grandpa who's there for the first grandchild.
Right.
And
right.
So, wonderful resource. We are at the end of our segment here, Lisa. It goes so quickly.
It does, doesn't it?
Enjoyed having you.
My
pleasure. Before we go, though, I want to let our listeners know, if they want to catch this segment, this show in its entirety, they can go to the Cypress Home Care website, cypresshomecare.com, and click on the media link. If we're coming into the holidays and need some respite time, some time to go be on your own and rejuvenate yourself, Cypress can provide those in-home care services at 602-264-8009. Call and we can assist with that. And Lisa, thank you so much for your time here.
It has been my entire pleasure. Thank you so much. I'm so glad we got to meet and to talk about something that oftentimes people feel a little uncomfortable talking about. So thanks, those of you who are listening, for being with us and helping us get the word out to be helpful to
That's
others
right.
in our community.
Make it a great day.
There's no place like home. You've been listening to Bob Roth's Health Futures. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call Cypress Home Care Solutions at 602-264-8009. That's 602-264-8009. Or visit cypresshomecare.com. Be sure to join Health Futures with Bob Roth every Friday at noon, right here on Money Radio 1510 and 105.3 FM.
Henderson's Nationwide Best Stocks Radio Show is now on Money Radio 1510 AM and 105.3 FM. Every morning from 9 to 10 a.m., professional money manager Bill Gunderson will talk about the economy, markets, and the best stocks now. Bill Gunderson is also the inventor of the Best Stocks Now app and the writer of the weekly Best Stocks Now newsletter. If you like to invest in the markets, this is the show for you. You will not want to miss one episode. Visit GundersonCapital.com for more info. That's GundersonCapital.com.
Money Radio 1510 and 105.
105.3 FM.
KFNN Mesa, Phoenix. With the market still settling, the Dow's up 11 points at 23,527. The S&P 500 up 7 at 2586. The NASDAQ up 47 at 6762. Gold down $7 at $12.70 an ounce. And oil's up $1.09, trading at $55 a barrel.
When people want to talk about money, this is the place they come to. And there's more on the way after this break for the latest news. And we begin.